I would say the instruments exist, meaning referendums. We have the experience of it in California, but they're very blunt. And today it's irresistible on the part of citizens and also of government to engage citizens in direct democracy. It's going to be harder and harder with technology, with access to information, access to communications to stop that. The question is, how do you engage citizens in a way that's constructive? How do you inform citizens? How do you make sure that issues like Brexit or others are deliberated so people understand the unintended consequences so that they vote in an informed way and it's not just populist contest? So that's the difficulty. It's the opportunity, but also the difficulty.
If I could give an example, just yes, an example please. Of that, just to be concrete, is what happened in Ireland. In Ireland, there were several questions that the Parliament wanted to have the country decide, including a highly emotional issue of whether abortion should be outlawed. Section 9, I think, of the Irish Constitution. So rather than just throwing a referendum out there that says, what do people think? They first convened a series of citizen assemblies, which are scientifically, randomly chosen citizens that represent, you know, the demographics and the gender and so on of the whole society, that met over a period of weeks with moderators and with like a trial with pro and con, you know, with the prosecution and the defense and with experts, that would manage on this very polarizing issue to come to a consensus. In their case, the consensus was that we're not for abortion or against abortion, but it shouldn't be outlawed in the Constitution. This was a way in which a highly volatile issue was taken and a polarization was reduced, a compromise was reached, and it was removed from the Constitution. So
strikingly, there was only one county in all of Ireland, in such a conservative country on the issue of abortion, there was only one county that voted against that, that wanted to keep abortion
illegal.
Exactly.
Now in Britain, we don't know. There's not only a crisis of democracy or constitutional crisis in Washington, but also in London and in Great Britain. We don't know what's going to happen with the Brexit deadline, but the former Prime Minister Gordon Brown, several members of the select committees of the Parliament are proposing citizen assembly to deal with the referendum issue. Either if there's a second referendum or if there's a confirmation vote, how to work through these issues in a way where you're outside the heat and the passion of electoral contests where parties are vying for power and the citizens themselves have a chance to be informed and to come to a consensus. Because in most cases, as everyone here knows, when partisans are vying for power, things get split and things get extreme. When you're not vying for power, but your citizens on the ground seem to be more practical and more pragmatic, and you can reduce. So this kind of process, this kind of participation without populism, we think is an important element for the future of democracy, precisely because there are more players than ever before in the political fray because of peer-driven social media. So you now have an environment which is very different from the founding fathers, and very different from when direct democracy was introduced in California, for example. So one of the updates, one of the renovations, is to renovate institutions so they can deal with this new reality of the digital age.